Hey everyone, Matt here, and welcome to video number 2 in this training on intrusive thoughts. So in video number 1, we talked about this idea about how, you know, just because you have an intrusive thought isn't actually the problem, right? That having intrusive thoughts is a normal part of being human. And in this video, what I want to talk about is why a lot of the things we do to combat intrusive thoughts actually make them worse and actually keep us stuck in those cycles that that we get into, especially if we struggle with obsessive compulsive disorder. So one of the things that I wanted to introduce in this video is this concept of the white bear phenomenon, right? And it's this concept that was kind of taught and discovered by a man named Daniel Wegner, who was a social psychologist who did some really interesting studies back in the 1980s and early 1990s, I believe. And so he actually has a book titled White Bears and Other Unwanted Thoughts. And basically in his studies, what he did is he would have people come into a room, right? And these are people that are just normal people like you and me. And he would have one assignment for them, and it would be for the next X amount of minutes, don't think of a white bear, right? And what they found is that when people would actively try to push thoughts out of their mind, and these are thoughts that don't even bother them, right? Just the image of a white bear. You can even try it yourself if you want to for a quick experiment of just trying to not have the image of a white bear pop in your mind. And what you'll find is that the more and more you try not to think about something, what happens is the more and more you actually end up thinking about it. So with this concept of intrusive thoughts, right, these thoughts that we don't want that are, you know, disturbing or disgusting or, you know, bothersome to us, the more and more we try to push thoughts away, right, what happens is that they're actually going to appear more and more, and they're going to be more frequent and more intense. And so with this phenomenon of OCD, this is why that understanding that obsessive compulsive cycle is so important, right? Where you have that obsession and then you do that compulsive behavior and that you get some relief, and then it just reinforces that obsessive thought again and again. And like I said in the last video, a lot of the compulsions that we do are mental. So anything like thought suppression, right? Thought replacement, right? Or, you know, blocking thoughts, or, you know, trying to count or distract yourself, or questioning or ruminating all these thoughts, right? Why did I have that thought? Is that thought bad? Is that really what I want to do? You know, whatever, whatever. Anytime we react to intrusive thoughts in a compulsive manner, it's actually going to make them come back in a more frequent and more intense way. Now, why does that happen, right? Well, Daniel Wegner introduced in his research this phenomenon called the ironic process. And what that basically is that this idea of, well, when you try not to think of something, you actually think about it more. And he explained it like this. He explained that when you're trying not to think about something, there's part of your brain that is actively trying to push a thought away. So I'm actually trying to push the thought of a white bear away. And there's another part of my brain that's actively scanning to see if I'm thinking about something. So what's happening is there's actually two parts of my brain that are working almost against each other. So I'm actively scanning to see if that thought's available, right? If that thought's there, right? The thought of the white bear. And then I'm actively trying to push that thought away. But you see, by me even looking for that thought, I'm almost generating it right there. You know, so if I'm looking to see if I'm like, if there's a white bear in my head, then I'm almost actively generating that thought. And then if I'm scanning to see if I'm thinking about it, this alarm goes off in my head that says, oh, there it is, right? And so it's almost this loop that's gonna happen every time you're trying not to think about something. You're gonna almost subconsciously think about it, and then the alarm's gonna go off that you're having the thought, and then it just kind of spirals out of control after that. So you see, by trying to suppress thoughts or trying to push thoughts away or any of the mental compulsions that we do to try to get rid of our intrusive thoughts, we're actually going to most likely make them worse and make them more frequent. Okay, so the solution to that, obviously, is to stop stopping your thoughts, right? And that's what one of the things that Daniel Wegner came up with in his book was that was like one of his big solutions was like, don't try to control everything. It's okay to allow thoughts to happen. It's okay to have intrusive thoughts. That's part of being human, right? Everyone experiences thoughts that they don't like or that are uncomfortable from time to time, right? So having the thought, again, is not the problem. How you react to it is. And if you react to those intrusive thoughts by suppressing them or pushing away or trying to do a thought blocking or replacement, whatever, right? Anything you do, it's actually going to make them worse and make them more frequent. Okay, so that kind of concludes this video, number two, where we talk about, you know, why the things we do aren't actually effective and actually make them worse. To get a list of different mental compulsions, right, and things that you might be doing, and really kind of see a whole checklist and inventory where you can actually go through all your mental compulsions, go ahead and click the link below this video. I've actually put together a free checklist for you for mental compulsions, where you can start identifying your mental compulsions and seeing if there is anything that you're doing that's actually keeping you stuck in that loop. And I'll see you over on video number three, where I'm actually going to teach some different strategies and techniques that I use and that I teach to people to not only remove compulsive behaviors from your life, but kind of quiet down that voice of the mind and really reduce the frequency and power of intrusive thoughts. Okay, so again, my name's Matt. Please subscribe to this channel if you like this video. And again, click the link below this video and you'll be taken over to my website where you can download some free resources that will help you identify those compulsive behaviors and start breaking you out of that intrusive thought loop. So I'll see you over on video three, and I hope you have a great day.